Hello friends, my name is Kumar Manish. Now we are going to explain about suspension of a car. So let's start. Now you are seeing this animation. First is tire. A tire, American English, or tire, British English. The pronunciation is same, but writing method is different. A tire is a ring-shaped vehicle component that covers the wheel's rim to protect it and enable better vehicle performance. Most tires, such as those for automobiles and bicycles, provide traction between the vehicle and the road while providing a flexible cushion that absorbs shock. This is the tire. Next is rim. Rim supports the rubber tire. Next is disc brake. A disc brake is a type of brake that uses calipers to squeeze pairs of pads against a disc in order to create friction that retards the rotation of a shaft, such as a vehicle axle, either to reduce its rotational speed or to hold it stationary. The energy of motion is converted into waste heat, which must be displaced. Hydraulic disc brake are the most commonly used form of brake for motor vehicles, but the principles of a disc brake are applicable to almost by any rotating shaft. This is disc brake. Next is caliper. Disc caliper. The caliper is the part of disc brake that squeezes the pads against both sides of the rotor when the brake is applied. Hydraulic pressure generated by the driver's foot pressing on the brake pedal goes from the master cylinder to each brake caliper. Fluid pressure inside the caliper pushes one or more piston outward to apply the brake. This is disc caliper and this is disc brake. Now you are seeing this. This is disc brake. It is a wheel hub. A wheel hub supports the lugs of the car and houses the wheel bearings. It keeps the wheel spinning freely while keeping it attached to the vehicle. The wheel hub assembly makes it possible for you to have a smooth and hassle-free driving experience. It's found at the center of the wheel and plays a big role to the movement of those. The most essential use of the assembly is contain the wheel bearings, which allow the wheels to turn quietly and steadily. This is wheel hub, which is directly connected to the axle beam. Next is knuckle. The steering knuckle is the end joint which provides directional assistance as the inputs of the steering wheel. The steering knuckle is a part of the wheel hub, which is finally bolted to the wheels. Hence, the final directional changes are attended by the movement given to the steering knuckle. We will discuss about the steering. Steering like this. You are seeing this. This is rack and this is pinion gear. This is tie rod and this is ball joint and this is control arm and this is disc brake and this is axle beam. This is universal joint. The purpose of steering knuckle is to facilitate the steering of the vehicle by transferring the motion from the rack. This is rack. This is rack, which you are seeing this. and this is pinion gear. Okay, transferred from the rotation of the pinion due to the rotation of steering wheel. This is the steering wheel. Okay, the pinion due to the rotation of steering wheel to the wheels. Steering knuckle is that structure on the wheel hub to which the tie rod ends of the track rod transfer motion to the wheels. Tie rod ends and the track rod are the links of the steering system of the vehicle, which are designed according to the particular steering geometry. Next, we will discuss about axle beam. Which is axle beam? What is axle beam? The term axle shaft can sometimes be confusing. It is also often overlooked as a simple component in the entire axle system. For a typical beam axle, this term refers to the shaft that connect the differential side gears of the wheels or spline couples of the axle to the differential side gear, and a bolted flange attach the axle to the wheel and brake drum or a rotor. This is a axle beam. Next is coil spring. This is coil spring. This is coil spring. What is spring? Springs allow your car to absorb the energy of a bump or pothole without jarring the occupants of the car. Meant to last the lifetime of the vehicle, properly sized springs seldom need to be replaced. If we discuss about shock, shocks work to dampen the spring natural tendency to oscillate. A good way to test your shocks is to push on a corner of your car and observe how many times the car bounces. More than twice, definitely your shocks are worn. Dear friends, I hope you like this video. If you have not subscribed to this channel yet, please subscribe and share to this video and press the bell icon to get the notification of new videos on my channel. Dear friends, many thanks for watching this video.